गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर अर्चना तिवारी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, SPC गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज अजमेर. द टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट, एंड दिस इज़ रिलेटेड विद द पेपर फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस, एंड दिस इज़ अ पेपर ऑफ BCom पार्ट 3rd. Deals with the paper of business management, and this is the second paper of business management. Now we have already discussed the meaning of insurance as well as the features of insurance, then principles of insurance, and now today we are taking insurable interest. Now what is insurable interest? Insurable interest is a part of an entity's value for which an insurance policy is purchased to cover the risk of loss. And I think it is clear to you all that what is the meaning of insurance policy. We have already discussed in our previous lectures. Now, insurable interest is a requirement for the insurance of an insurance policy or for issuance of an insurance policy, making it legal, valid, and protecting against intentionally harmful acts. Entity is not subject to financial loss from an event, do not have an insurable interest, and cannot purchase an insurance policy to cover that event. So the meaning of insurable interest is a compulsory requirement. जब भी इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी बनाई जाएगी तो उसके लिए ज़रूरी है कि उसमें इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट होना ही चाहिए, ताकि पॉलिसी को लीगल माना जा सके, वैलिड माना जा सके. साथ ही साथ अगर कोई हार्मफुल एक्ट होने वाला है फ्यूचर में, तो उस हार्मफुल एक्ट से बचने के लिए इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट होना बहुत ही ज़रूरी है. नाउ द डेफिनेशन. Insurable interest is defined as the reasonable concern of a person to obtain insurance for any individual or property against unforeseen events such as death, losses, etc. जैसे कि हम जानते हैं कि इंश्योरेंस क्यों लिया जाता है, ताकि व्यक्ति के जीवन में होने वाली क्षति से उस या जो होने वाली दुर्घटना है उससे बचने के लिए हो सकता है, या मृत्यु होने पर उसके घर वालों को पैसा मिल सकता है. तो इंश्योरेंस केवल लाइफ इंश्योरेंस के संबंध में ही नहीं है, बल्कि हमने जैसे कि देखा कि फायर में भी हो सकता है, साथ ही साथ मरीन इंश्योरेंस के रूप में भी हो सकता है. सो इफ़ यू टेक द डिस्क्रिप्शन, अ पर्सन इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैव रीजनेबल इंटरेस्ट इन अ लॉन्गर लाइफ फॉर हिमसेल्फ, हिज फैमिली, बिजनेस, एंड हेंस इज इन नीड ऑफ एक्वायरिंग इंश्योरेंस फॉर दीज. Therefore, insurable interest is often related to ownership, relationship by law or blood, and possession. However, it is not an important element of life insurance contracts under modern law. A person is said to have insurable interest in something if he would suffer loss or get adversely affected if that property was lost or damaged, or would benefit financially from the property's safety or continued existence. In life insurance, a person has an insurable interest in another person when the death of that person would cause a financial, emotional, or another type of loss. इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट, अगर हम लाइफ इंश्योरेंस के बारे में बात करें, तो हम जैसे कि देखते हैं कि जब पर्सन की डेथ हो जाती है, उसको फाइनेंशियल मदद मिलनी चाहिए, या किसी अन्य तरह का उसको लॉस हो जाता है, तो उस केस में उसका इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट देख सकते हैं. अगर हम प्रॉपर्टी की बात करें, तो इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट इन द प्रॉपर्टी और लाइफ इज़ द बेसिस ऑफ इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसीज. द असेंशियल थिंग इज़ दैट देयर मस्ट बी सम प्रॉपर्टी, राइट, लाइफ और पोटेंशियल लाइबिलिटी कैपेबल ऑफ बींग इंश्योर्ड. ऑल्सो द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इंश्योर्ड एंड द सब्जेक्ट मैटर मस्ट बी रिकग्नाइज बाई लॉ. नाउ वाई देर इज़ अ नीड ऑफ इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट इन एन इंश्योरेंस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. सो वील कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज नीड ऑफ इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट इन एन इंश्योरेंस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. इट इज़ नॉट ओनली असेंशियल फॉर द इंश्योरेंस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू बी लेजिटिमेट दैट द पार्टीज बी कॉम्पिटेंट टू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट that it is done with free consent and that the transaction is legitimate, but it is also essential. And I think free consent का मतलब आप जानते ही हैं कि free consent वह होता है जिसमें कि contract में निम्नलिखित पांच में से कोई भी बात present नहीं हो या अनुबंध इन पांच में से ग्रसित न हो, जैसे कि कॉशन है, undue influence है, fraud है, mistake है और misrepresentation है, तो इन सब से ग्रसित नहीं होना चाहिए. The contract will be considered as a wager. Insurable interest in basic terms indicates that the insured or the policyholder must have a specific relationship with the subject matter of the insurance, whether it be life or property insurance. In marine and life insurance, the idea of insurance interest is particularly important. Now, there may be different types of insurable interest. Insurable interest can be divided into two categories. दो भागों में बांट सकते हैं. There are two types of insurable interest. Number one is contractual, यानी कि अनुबंध पर आधारित, और दूसरा है वैधानिक या statutory. Contractual insurance interest refers to an insurable interest that is required by an insurance contract in order to affect the policy, whereas statutory insurance interest refers to an insurable interest that is prescribed by specific laws dealing with insurance. Now, the term insurable interest is not defined in either the British Life Insurance Act of 1774 or the Indian Insurance Act of 1938. As seen in certain circumstances, interest in the subject matter of insurance is needed by law for the policy's legality, whether by specific statutory law such as the Marine Insurance Act 1906 of UK or by Section 30 of the Indian Contract Act 1872, which simply proclaims that all wagering contracts are void. This is the statutory shareholder or the interest required by law. If this agent is not present, the insurance is unlawful or unenforceable, and no agreement between the parties may be successful in removing this need. If the insurer does not raise the plea of interest in a contract action, the contract may decline to enforce the contract at its own discretion. Now, let's look at a case law that explains the distinction between these two types of insurable interest. In Macora versus Northern Assurance Company, 1925, one Macora insured the timber on his land against fire. He sold timber to a business in which he held the sole substantial shares. After the majority of the timber was destroyed by fire, he requested that he be compensated. The insurer was able to avoid complying with the requirement. The insured had no statutory interest in the firm's assets, despite the fact that he would suffer loss if the firm lost its property, nor did he have any contractual interest under the policy because he couldn't show interest at the time of the loss. Despite the fact that the insured had no statutory interest in the property, the policy was found to be not in wagering contract, since as the only shareholder, he had an interest. To put it another way, an insurable interest in it. So the time or duration of insurable interest, the period during which the insurable interest must be present, varies depending on the kind of insurable insurance contract. The question is whether insurable interest should exist at the time of contract formation or should it also exist until the contract is discharged. However, as we have seen in life insurance, insurance interest is required at the time of policy formation, but not thereafter, not even at the time of risk occurrence. As a result, it should be included in life insurance plans at the time of purchase. It is not required or exist at the time of the loss, or in the case of fire insurance, it is necessary both at the start of the coverage and when the risk occurs. In certain ways, it may be claimed that insurance interest is demanded twice in fire insurance because it is considered as both a personal contract and indemnity contract. the insurance interest is required at all times. Even the onus of proving that the fire was set on purpose is on the insurer, not the insured. The presence of insurable interest is required only at the moment of the loss in a maritime insurance contract. Now, who has an insurable interest? The simplest explanation is that the property owner has an insurable interest in it. Now, the conclusion of insurable interest. The world we live in is full of hazards and uncertainty. Individuals, families, business, building and investment are all vulnerable to various dangers. These include the danger of losing one's life, health, possessions and property, among other things. While it is not always feasible to avoid unfavorable occurrences from occurring, the financial industry has devised solutions that safeguard individuals and organizations from such losses by providing financial resources to compensate them. Insurance is a financial instrument that lowers or eliminates the cost of a loss or the effect of a loss caused by various risks, provides financial security throughout one's life. An insurance policy relieves strain and worry about on by unforeseen negative situations. It makes a significant contribution to living a stress-free existence. So this was the topic, insurable interest. Now on our next turn, we'll be continue with different types of insurances.